Welcome back, wonderful people, and we are back with some interesting news about Warzone, of course. And just a couple of hours ago, we received a brand new update, which basically is heavy around 200 megabytes, so it's not a big one, but we will go now through this update and the patch notes to see what we got in Warzone today. But before I start this topic, I want to thank you all wonderful people for supporting our channel. We are on the road to 1000 subscribers, and I'm hoping for this to happen at the end of this week, because we are having roughly 100 subscribers per day, which is absolutely unbelievable. I thank you all for your kind support, and I hope that you will continue supporting our channel, because that's the only way we can bring you even better content in the future. And now back to the topic, which is the brand new update we got for Warzone. And I'm going now to get through the patch notes. And first we have here general fixes. Fix for an issue where explosive rounds on the Rytec AMR could still be equipped in CDL modes. I don't know what that is, but whatever it is, it's good that they fix it finally. Fix for an error player could receive when opening the weapon armory. Okay, that was a quite annoying thing. It's good that they fixed that. Fixed for an exploit in the shooting range trial. I have no clue what's that, but it's good. Like, every time when they fix something, it's absolutely brilliant that we have those fixes. And there were some quite new changes in regards of the weapons. FAL, a very dangerous FAL, I would say. Increased headshot damage, 2 hit at range with 1 headshot. This is good. I was recently complaining that FAL is absolutely brilliant weapon on a mid and close range combats, but it was absolutely terrible in a long range combats. Of course, if you are a legitimate player, if you are a cheater, absolutely everything works for you, but it was quite annoying. And the second thing in regards of the FAL is reduced near damage, limbs and lower torso always 3 shots. That's kind of realistic, I would say, because I had a couple of rounds that basically people were jumping on me and it took just 2 shots and they were down. So they actually balanced the FAL, which I like the most, so I'm going to give it a shot tonight to see what have we got there. And the next one here is Holger 26. Increased damage range and increased ADS speed. I think that Holger actually needed a little bit of a buff as well, because that weapon, I haven't got too much of experience with it, but that weapon is very nice. And I loved it when I tried it a couple of times, but I felt it's too weak. And the most important in this update is Bruen MK9, reduced damage range. Now, this was absolutely annoying thing. Everybody is playing with Bruen, and I don't have any problems with that, but the cheaters are also playing with Bruen, and besides them cheating all the time, they also have an advantage of this overpowered weapon. So yesterday, for example, I played with my fellow Easter egg hunter Kevin. We played a couple of rounds of plunder, and we basically got in conflict in the garage of the stadium, where basically two gentlemen were trying to glitch into the server room where this code for the executive room is. So they were trying to glitch all the time, and we were trying, I would say, to stop them. So it was basically a small fight in the very small place. And this guy that played with Bruen, he smoked me at least 10 times from absolutely unbelievable distance. So he was at one side of the garage, I was on the completely other side of the garage, stadium garage. And he just, I didn't have a single chance. And I'm playing with AK-47 with a decent scope, so I didn't have an absolute chance not to see that. I'm not talking of seeing him, but it was absolutely like bullets were flying from absolutely everywhere. And I was watching his kill cam, and basically he was using 3.0 scope, and the bullets were just hitting me and making absolutely unbelievable damage. And not just that, no recoil at all, which is also very annoying. Like, this is a light machine gun, or as I would like to say, heavy weaponry. Like, it has to have some kind of a recoil. This guy, zero recoil. Absolutely unbelievable. So I'm perfectly happy that they finally started to nerf Bruin MK9, because it's simply too strong. And I covered a couple of cheaters as well, and they were all playing with Bruin. So I don't want for you to get me wrong, I'm not calling everybody that plays with Bruin a cheater. There is also a very decent and a very good gamers that are playing with the Bruin, and that's absolutely fine. But the problem with this weapon is that it was an absolute beast when you are exploiting the system, when you have all of these attachments and everything that the basically cheaters are doing. So I'm talking about this strike packs for the controllers on the consoles. I'm talking about Kronos Max, where you basically can adjust to have a zero recoil on every weapon. And I'm talking about the PC cheaters as well, where they have, besides having all of these wall hacks and everything, they also have this anti-recoil things. And it was so annoying, because each of these guys were playing with Bruin. And honestly speaking, I don't even have that weapon unlocked. I tried it a couple of times because my friend also plays with it, but I simply, when I saw that everybody is playing with the same weapon, especially when I saw it's a kind of a cheating weapon, I just stopped. I didn't even had a wish to unlock it. So I'm absolutely happy and thrilled that they are finally nerfing this weapon, because it's needed so much. And I would say last but not least update for this, or I would say addition for this update, is M91. Again, we are speaking about light machine gun, and we have increased near damage and increased ADS speed, which is fine, I would say, because again, I'm talking about Bruin. Bruin had absolutely distinctive advantage in front of absolutely every light machine gun. I won't even mention the assault rifles, because if you compare Bruin to assault rifle, that you simply can't compare it, because it's not comparable. So I think that what they are doing over here is they are slowly trying to balance all the light machine guns, which is absolutely good thing to do, because like myself, I want to have my own style of play. I want to have my own style weapons, I would say, and I'm trying to master a weapon. For example, here I'm playing with AK-47. I don't know much people who like AK-47, because honestly speaking, it's very hard to control it. Like, recoil is absolutely unbelievable, but I'm not a good aimer. So basically what I need is something strong, something powerful, where I can down my enemy in a couple of shots. So I cannot hold aim steady, for example, if I'm shooting from, let's say, M4, 60 bullets. I'm not able to hold on to 60 bullets at one target. That's almost impossible for me. And I'm playing on PS4 with the controller. So I need something very strong, but on the other hand, reliable and with not too much of a recoil. So basically what I'm doing here with AK-47 is that I'm trying to master it. So just having my own play style. So at the end of this video, I want to say that this update is very good. It's indeed small update, but it's very good. It brought some technical issues up and resolved some technical issues that we had previously, especially with the weapons. Don't forget that on Friday the 14th at 12 again, we will have a new progression on the Easter egg in regards of the COD 2020, and I have my fingers crossed that we will finally have some progress with the Easter eggs that we are having here in Verdansk. And yes, I'm speaking about bunkers. Like, I'm getting more and more, maybe it would be too hard word to say disappointed, but I'm getting more and more annoyed with the fact that months have passed and that we haven't got any single progress in regards of the bunkers. So please, Activision and Infinity Ward, give us something on Friday, please. So, wonderful people and fellow Verdansk citizens, this would be all for this broadcast. I hope you enjoyed this video, and please let me know what do you think about the FAL and Bruin update. Are you playing with those weapons, and what is your best score? Until next time, I wish you all the best and stay frosty.